Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you may be using colors in the calendar app wrong. So I often get questions or see comments from people about colors in the calendar app on the Mac, iPhone, or iPad. And these questions seem to indicate that a lot of people don't understand what colors mean in the calendar app. So for instance, here I am in the calendar app, and you can notice a variety of different events on my calendar. And they're using a variety of different colors. There's some red, there's some green, there's an orange, there's some blue. It might seem that you have the ability to color code events. So you can decide that some events deserve to be red while others deserve to be green and just set the color for each event as you like. But that's not what these colors are about. If you look in the left sidebar here, you'll see your accounts and you'll see the calendars under those accounts. If you don't see the left sidebar, click this button here at the top, and it should appear. The sidebar shows you accounts, in this case, iCloud, Gmail, and other, which are mostly subscription calendars. So if you have just one account, you may just see iCloud here, for instance. If you have multiple accounts, you may see iCloud, Gmail, and other services. If you go to calendar settings, and then go to accounts here, you'll see all of the potential accounts. So these are internet accounts that you've set up in system settings. And you could decide to enable or disable this account in calendar. Just because you're using, say, Gmail on the Mail app doesn't mean you have to use Gmail for calendars. You can simply turn it off and you could see it's removed from the left sidebar here. This is in fact how I use it. I do use Gmail for one of my email accounts, but I don't want it used at all in calendar. So I've got Gmail disabled here in calendar. But you may, for instance, have Google as your calendar for work. So you may want it enabled, and then you may use iCloud for other calendars like your personal and family calendars. Now, for each account, you could also have multiple calendars. So a calendar is like a database of events. Any single event would be in a calendar, which is inside of an account. So in this case, under iCloud, I have three calendars, work, personal, and family. Under Gmail or Google, I've got one, and that's also called personal. Others may have more or fewer calendars in each account. But the important thing to know is you've probably got multiple calendars, which is normal, and each calendar has a color assigned to it. In this case, red for work, green for personal, orange for family, and then this blue for the personal calendar under Google. And the subscription calendars, like for instance, US holidays here, this one is a different shade of blue. So to illustrate this, imagine you've got two accounts connected to your calendar, iCloud and Google, and there are also calendars under subscriptions. You can see here that you've got three calendars under iCloud, two under Google, and one additional subscription calendar, the standard US holidays calendar. If the color for the personal calendar in your iCloud account is set to red, then all of the events for that personal calendar will appear with the red color when you look at them in the calendar app. Each calendar has its own color, and you'll see that color for every event. So these two red-colored events, meeting and project due, they are red because they are simply in the work calendar under iCloud. The two green ones here, family dinner and doctor, those are green because they are in the personal calendar in iCloud. And this one here, for a lunch appointment, that's blue because it's in the personal calendar under Gmail. And you may be wondering what's different about this orange event here. It's orange, so it indicates that it's in the family calendar under iCloud. But why is the entire title of the event shaded rather than just a simple line of color to the left? Well, these events here all have a specific start and end time. This is from 7 to 8 p.m. Whereas this event here is an all-day event, and you can see all-day has been checked here. So if this were a vacation and it were scheduled over 2 days, you could see how this becomes a line that stretches between dates. And the longer you make it, the longer the line gets, which makes sense, whereas these events with the single bit of color to the left of the title, they are just a portion of that day. If you switch to, say, week view here, you notice the same concept applies here. You'll see the shading goes from the beginning to the end. So just like it does here when you're looking at day view and the shading will go between days, on the week view, when you actually have time in the vertical axis, the shading will show you the length of the event. So if I were to make this event longer, say this, you could see how the shading continues there, just as it does in this monthly calendar if this event were to extend across multiple days. So what a lot of people are getting wrong is using color on a per event basis instead of realizing that it's indicating which calendar it's in. So for instance, somebody may look at this event right here and then decide, oh, they want this to be green. So they see the color here, they click here and they change it to green. But what they've actually done is they've moved it from the work calendar to the personal calendar. So when you change the color, you're actually moving the event from one event database, one calendar, to another event database, another calendar. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MACMOST through Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. So what about if you want to have specific colors for specific events without moving them to a different calendar? Well, you have an interesting option, and that is to simply change the title to include a color in there. Now, you can't color the text. That's not a property of the title here, but you can include emoji characters. So you can either use the FN or globe key and E to bring up the emoji in Special Character Viewer, or the older keyboard shortcut Control, Command, and Space. And sometimes that brings up some suggestions, and you have to use it a second time to actually bring up all of the different emoji characters. And you can browse through here, and of course, the emoji characters are filled with color. So you could decide to use a specific emoji character here to represent some kind of event. So for instance, you may want to use something like one of these food items here to represent a dinner meeting. So you can use this and you can see how it adds a little splash of color. Let's put it at the beginning there like that and apply. And you can see now I've got a little bit of color here in the title of the event. And maybe you can reuse your favorite emoji characters to represent different kinds of things. Like whenever a meeting involves a meal, you can always use the same emoji character. But you could also use simple color blocks and circles. So I can search here simply for a color, like for instance, green, and you could see there are a lot of green emoji characters, and there are a few that are basically just about the color. There's the green heart here, but there's also a green square, and there's a green circle. So if you use one of these, like that, then you could see how this adds a color there that even overpowers the calendar color. So you could use this green dot to represent something. It's easy actually to even copy and paste it from this event to, say, another event like this, and then have that same color, even though these two events are in different calendars. And you can even use multiple ones of these. You don't have to stick with just one if you really want the color to stand out. And if you don't really care about the color of the individual calendar, you could certainly change it. You can control click, right click, or two finger click on the calendar here. And notice you can choose one of the 7 standard colors, and you could simply make all of your calendars the same color here, so that the color doesn't actually represent anything. You could also choose custom color here and then choose from any of the color picker options here. And if you choose white, notice how you just get this little gray line and black text. If you choose black, you get a black line and black text. So it's fairly devoid of color and then ready for you to add your own color emoji to things. Although I would recommend against assigning the same color to each of your calendars, because it makes it hard to differentiate things. And then you could accidentally assign, say, a personal event to your work calendar or vice versa. It's better to have them all have their own color there and then use emoji characters if you want more color in the title. And also note that you could do this with subscribe calendars as well. So for instance, I've hidden my calendars under other, but if I turn on US holidays, I can change the color for US holidays to something else, or assign a custom color to it. And then don't be afraid to switch these on or off, and also switch on or off your other calendars to filter what you're seeing there, depending upon what you're looking for at the moment. And when creating a new event, remember, if you select the calendar here on the left, and then you use the plus button, or just double click in here, then it will use that calendar for the new event. So while you can change it afterwards, it helps if your first step is to select the correct calendar and then create the event. So I hope this helps some of you who may have been confused about what the colors in the calendar apps mean. Thanks for watching. Want to know about every new MACMOST video each week? Sign up for the absolutely free MACMOST email newsletter at MACMOST.com/newsletter.